Hello, Space Lab. I'm Emily Rice, a professor of astronomy at the College of Staten Island, and I'm here today to answer your questions. The first question is, if I was able to stand on a neutron star, would I become extremely dizzy? What effect would this extreme rotational speed have on the body? Would the neutron star rotate so quickly that the stars would appear trailed as they do in a long exposure photograph? If you were able to stand on a neutron star, which you can't, but if you were able to stand on a neutron star, you would definitely be extremely dizzy. Neutron stars rotate at least once every few seconds, and some of them rotate thousands of times a second. This huge rotational speed is definitely going to be bad for the body, but what's worse is the huge gravity at the surface of a neutron star, because a neutron star is, by definition, just a mass of neutrons. It's as dense as an atomic nucleus. It's a huge mass, something that's several times more massive than the sun, condensed into a region that's just a handful of miles across. So the gravity on these things would absolutely crush any person that tried to stand on them. So if you could stand on the surface of a neutron star, you would absolutely see star trails or maybe even just a blur, because the human eye is only sensitive to changes at about 1/10 of a second or so. And some of the fastest neutron stars rotate thousands of times per second. So you're literally going around hundreds of times in the time it takes your eye and your brain to receive a signal. And so you would just see a blur. The second question is, what is a white dwarf made of and what is its energy output compared to our sun shortly after being formed? A white dwarf is really a stellar remnant. It's like the corpse of a star that's left over after it explodes. So the outer layers are blown off, and then the core of the star collapses. And what's left over is the carbon and oxygen that was essentially the ash left over from the hydrogen and helium fusion that happened during the star's lifetime. Its temperature is very, very high. It starts out at about 10 or 20,000 degrees Kelvin, much hotter than the surface of the sun. But these objects are still actually very, very faint because they're so small. A white dwarf that started out about the mass of the sun is now only about the size of the Earth. And so it's much more dense than the sun, much smaller, and so a much smaller power output despite being so, so hot. The third question is, in 2 billion years, when the sun starts heating, will Mars ever become hot enough to boil its CO2 and produce an atmosphere habitable to life? So we know that the sun will get hotter in a few billion years, if not sooner. And as Mars gets hotter, then the CO2 that's frozen in the surface right now will sublimate into the atmosphere, will go directly from the solid state into the gas state. But the Martian atmosphere is already over 90% carbon dioxide. So if we just sublimate more carbon dioxide from the surface into the atmosphere, it'll probably become a runaway greenhouse effect instead of a nice stable warming of the atmosphere. And so chances are, even if Mars did become habitable for life for a little while, it won't last for very long, and it probably won't be long enough to develop life of its own, because we think, at least for the case of the Earth, that takes billions of years to happen. Thanks for your great questions. If you have a question for the next expert, leave it in the comments below. The question with the most likes will be answered in the following round.